Good morning, students. I, Vijaya, your teacher of English, welcome you all to Rishikul Online School. Dear students, today I am going to discuss with you all Chapter 7, The Necklace from the book Footprints Without Feet. And this is Module 4. Ma'am Loisel now knew the horrible life of necessity. She did her part, however, completely heroically. It was necessary to pay this frightful debt. She would pay it. They sent away the maid, they changed their lodgings, they rented some room in an attic. She learned the odious work of a kitchen. She washed the dishes, she washed the solid linen. She took down to refuse to the street each morning and brought up the water, stopping at each landing to catch her breath, and clothed like a woman of people. She went to grocers, the butchers and the fruiterers, and her basket on her arm, shopping, haggling to the last of her miserable money. And this was all due to the lost necklace. The course of Loisel's life completely changed due to the necklace. The husband worked evenings, putting the books of some merchants in order. And nights, he often did copying at 5 sous a page. And this life lasted for 10 years. At the end of 10 years, they had restored all. Ma'am Loisel seemed old now. She had become a strong, hard woman, the crude woman of the poor household, her hair badly dressed, her skirts up, her hands red. She spoke in a loud tone and washed the floors with large pails of water. The real cause of Matilda's ruin was her pride, her materialistic aspiration, coupled with her dishonesty, paved the way for her ruin. She could have avoided it by learning to accept her current situation and being content with what she had. But sometimes when her husband was at the office, she would sit herself before the window, think of that evening party of former days, of the ball where she was so beautiful, so flattered. How would it have been if she had not lost the necklace? Who knows? How singular is life and how full of changes. How small a thing will ruin or save one. One Sunday, as she was taking a walk in the champs to rid herself of the cares of the week, she suddenly perceived a woman walking with the child. It was Ma'am Frostier, still young, still pretty, still attractive. Now, whenever Ma'am Loisel was alone in the house, she would think of those days when she was so beautiful, especially the day of the ball where she was a great success. Ma'am Loisel was affected. Should she speak to her? Yes, certainly. And now that she had paid, she would tell her all. Why not? She approached her. Good morning, Jean. Her friend did not recognize her and was astonished to be so familiarity addressed by this common personage. She stammered. But madam, I do not know. You must be mistaken. No, I am Matilda Loisel. Her friend uttered a cry of astonishment. Oh, my poor Matilda, how you have changed. Now, while Mrs. Loisel talked to Ma'am Frostier, her friend, who was still attractive, still young, still beautiful, then Madame Frostier was unable to recognize this woman. was quite changed. And then Madame Loisel told her that she was her friend Matilda Loisel. Frosia was astonished. She was surprised to see the present condition of poor Matilda. It was surprising. "Yes, I have had some hard days since I saw you, and some miserable ones, all because of you." "Because of me? How is that? You recall the diamond necklace that you loaned me to wear to the minister's ball?" She said, "Yes, very well." "Well, I lost it." "How's that, since you returned it to me?" She said, "I returned another to you exactly like it, and it has taken us 10 years to repay for it. You can understand that it was not easy for us who have nothing. But it is finished. I am decently contented." Ma'am Frostier stopped short. She said, "You say that you bought a diamond necklace to replace mine?" "Yes." "You did not perceive it then. They were just alike." And she smiled with proud and simple joy. Ma'am Frostier was touched and took both her hand as she replied, "Oh, my poor Matilda, mine were false. They were not worth over 500 francs. So this is the end of the story. Matilda could change herself if she had told the whole truth to her friend Madame Frostier, but she did not. So whenever you find any problem, talk to your friend, and always remember, always be truthful. Those who are truthful, they never suffer. Thank you for today. We will meet in our next module. Till then, bye-bye.